You've been thinking about it. Blue Water Surgical Center, bluewatersurgery.com.
Ooh, 100-year-old scotch. Now, that's really something. Yeah. It's 1910. We are in a beautiful pub. No, we're not. We're really in the rehearsal space for Theater Alive. They're putting on My Fair Lady, which will be at the Cleary. Tickets available at the Cleary box office. The actual production taking place, Brian, at the Chrysler Theater, yes, starting in early March. Brian Raisbeck is the director and also one of the performers. I know you're thinking this is the Wednesday wrap. Well, we've got somebody, a guest host, I guess you could say, and what everybody's rapping about aside from your production. The Olympics kick off this week. Are you pumped?
I can't wait. I know we're very busy with the theater, but I am waiting for Friday night, the opening, and also the, you know, we all should feel proud of Canada. I can't wait. I follow on TV that they didn't have enough snow. They're bringing it in with the straw. I can't wait. Friday night, I'd be in front of the TV.
Yeah, they've got helicopters picking snow up off the mountain and relocating it. It's
fabulous.
It's bizarre.
We'll do it. You
know? This is an odd one for me because when the Olympics first started, I was a little apprehensive to get caught up in what I considered the corporate hype. I mean, it started early with the clothing and gotta believe and all. But you know what? I've been seduced. It's a great marketing campaign, and now I'm thoroughly thrilled about this.
And the whole carrying of the torch, I was reading in the Windsor Star today that they haven't decided who's going to carry it last. It could be Walter Gretzky, you know, it could be Olympian, like former Olympians, and I'm not sure, they haven't actually said it yet, but just the carrying of the torch for all these weeks and months, it's just
fantastic. Zigzag back
across Canada, amazing.
How do you feel about Arnold Schwarzenegger carrying the torch? Apparently, they're going to bring the governor up, Terminator.
I'm not sure I like that.
No, I don't get the connection.
I don't like it at all, actually.
A little bit of butt kissing or something.
I don't like it at all. It should be a Canadian.
Yeah.
And Terry Fox is, I believe, his father or a brother or something. They thought of him. It should be somebody who's Canadian. That really shocked me today when I read that. No, yeah, he's a good guy and all this, but he's American.
I know. I just don't see
I don't get it at all.
I guess one of the things I'm most excited about at this Olympics is they started a program years ago called Own the Podium, which initially kind of sits against the ideals of the Olympics, which is supposed to be do your best. Mm-hmm. But we've come down with this Own the Podium, we're going for it. And now, according to Professor Daniel Johnson, who predicts medal outcomes and has an accuracy rate of something like 94%, he's predicting through his system that he's come up with, that Canada will win one more medal than the United States, and I believe Norway, something like 27 or 26 medals, and they will actually win the most medals.
Oh my God.
Can you imagine?
No, I hope so. Like, you know, we are a Winter Olympic kind of country, of course, you know,
and never won gold on our own soil.
No, I know, but maybe this year with the skiing and alpine and, you know, whatever they call it, and hockey will be there, hopefully, and we need it. I think we need it.
I think we do need it in hockey, because
yes,
Olympic hockey hasn't been. The one thing that I'm excited to see is there's usually one emerging star from every Olympics, regardless of the location. Mm-hmm. People remember Ross Rebliati for his drug smoking with a snowboarder.
Right.
Saleh and Peltier for that stolen gold medal that was later awarded, remember? There's usually one sort of narrative that I think, and I'm going out on a limb here, I think it's going to be a girl by the name of, I think it's Melissa Hollingsworth.
Yes, her name's been coming up a
skeleton
lot.
Skeleton
yes.
competitor. And apparently she's easy on the eyes, well-spoken, and a defending world champ, I think.
I know. Oh, I hope so. You know, we need it. We've gone through tough times here, as the United States and the whole world has, but without sounding corny or cliche, we really need this. And there's a pride building for us to watch this, and hopefully people support the Olympics here in Canada. We don't get it very often. So
no, I think this is going to be a massive success.
Oh, I hope so.
On the bottom line financial statement at the end of the games, I'm not sure, but I think to a lot of people who don't live in Vancouver, won't matter.
I'm sorry, I heard something on TV today that almost every ticket is sold out, pre-sold out. And so that's a really good sign. So I got a feeling that they're going to be able to pay for the Olympics, and almost every ticket is sold out. Actually, one of our costume ladies, as a present, her husband's taking her out to Vancouver to see three events.
Yeah. Wow, that's okay. Speaking of events,
yes,
a lot of events that you never see any other time other than the Olympics. Which is your, I guess, favorite of the less common. So you can't pick hockey, you can't pick, I'm not even going to let you pick skiing.
And my wife's too, is skating, figure skating. I love the figure skating so much. And the bobsledding's great too. It's so fast though.
Yeah.
I mean, it's gone before you know. But we look forward to the figure skating more than anything. My wife and I love it. It's fantastic.
I'm going to stick with that skeleton thing. I think that skeleton is just going to be a huge story for Canada. Just so bizarre, tobogganing head first.
I know.
It's wild.
I hope so.
Well, here, cheers to the games.
Absolutely.